Good morning everybody on Newton Land. Jamie Powell back for another video today, and today I'm going to go to Bournemouth. Going to go to the cinema to see the new film by M. Night Shyamalan called Old. And it's about these people that arrive at a beach and every like hour or 30 minutes they turn like a year older or something like that. That's what I believe the story is about. I've seen the trailer, so you know what it's about. They'll just get old randomly. And I want to go see what the hell is all going on. Now, I've heard a lot of mixed reviews about it. Some have said it's really good. Some have said it's all right. And some say it's absolute dog shit. Well, I want to check it out for myself. So I'm going to go and see it today. I do love the guy's work. Even his weaker films, I just love his work. So we're going to do that. And whilst we're down Bournemouth, might as well pop into HMV. They got a few bits and bobs I'm going to try and find today. And it's the last day for the Arrow sale and the 20% off everything in store. So might have to go and pick up a couple of things before all that ends. So without further ado then, people, let's get going. Cue the intro. Then into HMV, and we've got Nipper the dog, and we've got some commemorative mugs as well. Very nice indeed. What's this then? Oh, there he is. There's old Nipper. Wait, get down. Yes, very nice teddy bear there. Might be worth picking up. Like I said about the mugs, I really do like this mug. It's really quite cool. But then again, I really like this mug as well. Which mug is better? There's only one way to find out. And they've also got some tea towels and cushions, and we've also got this bottle here, which is very nice but a bit small for my drinking ability. That sounded worse than it than I anyway, carry on. And we've got some Blu-rays here. The Hunt, and I said that correctly, people. The Lie is Spreading, very good film. Schlock, this is a film which looks right up my street, about a man in an ape suit. We've got Southland Tales with Dwayne Jockson. Oh, I say how personal. Johnson, The Rock. Getting a rock on. And we've got The Bird and the Crystal Plumage out tomorrow in 4K box set. And we've also got another Dario Argento film here, The Cat of Nine Tails. I've not seen this one. Let me know in the comments, is it worth watching? Also, we've got Enter the Dragon. We saw this the other day, and yes, it's come down in price if you have the 20% off. Fantastic. Right then, let's go to the cinema to go and see Old. We've arrived at the cinema to see Old. And just so you know, why am I doing a voiceover? Well, we're about to see Kevin Costner in a canoe. That's right. Welcome to Waterworld. home, people, hooray. And it's been a really nice afternoon. And I just got back from the cinema, as you've seen, been to see, the new film by M. Night Shyamalan. And it's a story about all these people that come together and arrive at this secluded beach. And once they get there, after about an hour or so, they realise things aren't quite as it seems. And they start ageing pretty much by every half an hour, like by a year. And they all sort of club together to try and find a way to get out of this scenario before they die. And because some of them, like them, in their middle age, they got about a day before they hit another 50 years older. So it's a race against time to try and get out of this situation. And this film is quite a complex film, and a lot of people have been shitting all over it. A lot of people have been laughing at it, and a lot of people just said it's middle of the road. Now, I personally think that this is a flipping brilliant film. I loved it. I really got invested in the story. I liked the characters. I liked the fact that they all brought something different with their characters. A lot of people say they're generic, but I don't think so. I think they're just normal people put in an unusual circumstances. And it does go at quite a good pace. The first sort of like quarter an hour to 20 minutes is setting up all the characters. They go to the hotel and then they get they all put together on a bus and go down to this beach. And yeah, but then it sort of goes at a pretty good pace. So a couple of dippy moments where it sort of stops and the characters talk for a bit. Is that allowed in films anymore? And but no, I really did get invested in this story. And it was intriguing to see where it was going to go, how it was going to end up, and what was going to happen. And of course, with M. Night Shyamalan, he tends to put in like a twist towards the end. Is there a twist in this movie? Kind of, but I'm not going to go down that road. I don't want to spoil this movie for anybody because it's a film you need to see, I think. If you're a fan of M. Night Shyamalan's movies, then you'll probably like this. Is it one of his best films? I would say no, not up in the top range like Signs, Unbreakable, Sixth Sense. This is more in the middle of the road sort of stuff, like The Visit, Lady in the Water. It's in that sort of category. I do like it very much. I think it's a very well-made film. Is it predictable? Maybe to some. I didn't quite see the ending coming, but I thought it was good. I thought it was overall a very good film, the direction, etc. How can I describe the film in tone, etc.? Basically, this is like if Stephen King wrote an episode of Lost, the TV series. That's how this film feels. It flows, like I said, at a good pace. The acting all around is great. The writing is fine. I do like the fact that M. Night has a certain style with his directing and his writing. You can tell it's a film by him. And some of the things that people say, you probably wouldn't say in that circumstance, but each to their own, I guess. But honestly, though, overall, despite its flaws, I thought it was a really well-polished film. And it maybe is a bit too long, it does have slow moments, but overall, I found this to be very enjoyable. And yeah, like I said, people are laughing at this. I can't think of one thing in this film that people are laughing at. I mean, I know it's a bit absurd and a bit weird, but it's you know, it's like a mystery fantasy horror film at times. And it's just quite creepy at times as well. I think it's all very well done and they did what they could with it. It is quite depressing at times. I'm going to say this to you now. This is quite a sad film a lot of the way, but I was happy with its conclusion. I liked the way it started. The bit in the middle was great, and I thought it ended well. So that's what I can say. The music fit the film perfectly. The cinematography at times is great. The camera work is very smooth. The acting for the cast are great. There's not one bad person acting here, in my opinion. It's not perfect. It does have its flaws. Like I said, it's a little bit too long. It's too slow in places. It's a lot to swallow with the story. It's not very believable. There is no real explanation either. There's no epic conclusion to why all this is happening. But you get a sense of they know this and that's why they're dealing with it. But I'm not going to say no more because obviously I don't spoil films in my reviews. So if I was to grade this out of 5, I would say that I would give this 3.75. Not quite the 4 stars, but a very entertaining film. That's like 7.5 out of 10 for those who do it out of 10. I think it's a very good film, really worth watching. And yeah, if you go to see it at the cinema, why not? It's worth going to see. So yeah, very good film, recommend it. And it's in the middle of M. Night Shyamalan's movies. Right. As you see, I went to HMV earlier and I did get some pickups, quite a few pickups in fact. So I guess it's now time for a segment I like to call...
It's time for the shit that we bought. It's time for the shit that we bought.
Say bullshit.
for the shit that we bought. Oh!
Well, before we get to the HMV pickups, I did pop into CEX, which you didn't see. It was the same stuff they had in there the other day. But I picked up one DVD, which is He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, Volume 1. This is the first sort of six episodes. Haven't seen it in a very long time, and I'm going to do a comparison to the new one that's just come out on Netflix. Some people love it, some people hate it. I wanted to refresh my memory because I used to watch this as a kid, and now I've got the DVD just to remind myself of the first few episodes to get a taste of what to expect with the new one. I bought a couple of mugs because, well, I couldn't choose between either of them. I liked them both very much, and I was humming and hawing, which one should I get? So I decided to get both. They're only $2.99 each, so that's pretty cheap. And these are to commemorate the 100th anniversary of HMV, my favourite shop in the world. And I absolutely love it. And I thought, well, I'm going to support them because they're the only shop on the market, really, that sells brand new films of, like, boutique labels, etc. So HMV, a couple of mugs there. Really happy with these. I did buy some Blu-rays, and the first Blu-ray got...
My name's Nipper, and you're a fucking fat cunt. I don't know why you're laughing.
You need help, people.
Fucking bald-headed twat from Bournemouth. I'm off back to the shop. I'm not living with you, you farty old fuck.
So yeah, as you see, I bought Nipper the dog. Why not? He's cute, and me and the wife like teddy bears. And I thought, he's commemorating HMV. So he's like part of the staple of HMV. So I thought, pick him up anyway. I don't give a monkeys. But I did get by some Blu-rays. What? So the first Blu-ray I picked up was Southland Tales, and I was humming and hawing about this for some time now, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to give it a go. It stars Dwayne Johnson, Sean William Scott, Sarah Michelle Gellar, Nora Dunn, Christopher Lambert, John Larroquette, John Lovitz, Mandy Moore. It's got a hell of a cast in it, and I've heard good things, and tomorrow it goes back up to full price at $17.99, so I picked that up for $9.99. Pretty happy with that. Out tomorrow in 4K special edition, £30. No, thank you. But I got the standard version of Bird with the Crystal Plumage. Now, this is directed by the awesome Dario Argento, Dead Rise, Suspiria, etc. He is an incredible director, and I've never seen this one of his work. So I thought, why not pick it up? And it's $7.99. Tomorrow it goes up to $14.99. So very pleased to have that one and give it a go. The Hunt, and I said that correctly, this is a fantastic film. I started watching this the other night and I was hooked. It's such a harrowing story, but it's so well acted, so well written, so well performed. This is a fantastic film. I can't recommend it enough, and it's just amazing. I really do love this movie. It's a fantastic film, a Danish film starring the great, of course, what's his name? Mads Mikkelsen. Went right out of my head. But fantastic film, and I highly recommend it. $7.99, tomorrow $14.99. Schlock! Schlock is a strange one. I've never seen this movie, but I saw the trailer. There's a guy in an ape suit running around causing havoc. But I do love me some weird shit. It's directed by John Landis, who did The Blues Brothers and American Werewolf in London. And it's basically about, yeah, it says about a guy in an ape suit going around causing havoc. It looks really funny. It looks up my street. It's a bit bonkers. And we're all a bit bonkers. Again, in the era sale for $7.99. And the final pickup was Enter the Dragon. And this was originally $24.99, but because of the 20% off, this went down to $19.99. And I've been humming in the horror since I saw it on Thursday, was it? I saw it in the shop on Thursday, and I really wanted to get it, but I didn't pick it up. And I thought, well, now's the time to get it if I'm going to get it. So I thought, bugger it. So I went back, and they still had it, thank goodness. And this is the special edition of HMV version, which comes with a special high definition experience with a new remastered mix. It's also got a poster, there's a patch, there's postcards, and it's just very cool. And I really want to watch it. I've never seen this movie. Maybe I did when I was younger. I watched a hell of a lot of Jackie Chan and Bruce Lee and loads of that sort of movies when I was younger. So maybe I have seen it. Maybe this will jog my memory. But as this moment in time, I don't remember it. So really happy to pick this up. And yeah, Enter the Dragon, it's a classic. And that's it. Tomorrow I'm also going back to HMV because I've got a few pickups to pick up. Some pickups to pick up. And yeah, but we're going to be vlogging tomorrow. And yeah, so you shall see that tomorrow afternoon, evening, I guess. Probably evening by the time I get back. But thanks for watching this video. Like I said, really enjoyed. Old, great film, worth watching. And I've got some nice pickups from HMV. Great day. Right then, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care, stay safe, play safe. Please like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you again soon for more videos. Bye for now. Oh, my fucking bank balance.